Altiyan Jurek, best known as Altiyan Childs, is an Australian performer who topped the charts after winning the second season of XFACTOR Australia in 2010. On April 15th of this year, Altiyan published a five-hour video claiming he was initiated into the Freemasons and that Freemasonry is hiding the true world religion, Satanism. He goes on to reveal how every initiate must swear a vow of secrecy to never reveal the secrets of Freemasonry to anyone whatsoever, under penalty of having their body severed in two and their bowels burned to ashes, their throat slit, and their tongue torn out by the roots.
This is the sign you do upon entering and exiting the ritual room while facing the Grand Master. It stands for throat slit, and it goes like this.
They use symbolic gestures to flaunt their secret religion, such as the sign of the Master of the Second Veil, or the Hidden Hand, the sign of silence. As you move up the ranks of Freemasonry, the oaths of silence for taking each degree become more brutal, having your heart torn out and fed to wild beasts, your head struck off and placed on the highest spire of Christendom, destroying your business and reputation, and hanging you in your own home. Masonic rules clearly stipulate that the Lodge has the authority and obligation to uphold these mandates and penalize any member who violates them. Masonic rules also warn members from inviting the vulgar and profane. The profane is what they call the uninitiated, anyone outside their secret order. As one climbs the ladder of power in Freemasonry, each degree requires more barbaric acts from the initiate. From being humiliated and stepped on, drinking wine from a human skull, stabbing human skulls. And in one of the highest degrees, the initiate removes a blindfold to find a severed human head lying on the floor with a bloody knife beside it. He is instructed to take the knife in his right hand and the head in his left. Eventually, this leads the initiate to accept human sacrifice as a rite of initiation, which is the ultimate goal of this unholy hierarchy. 33rd degree Mason Manly P. Hall, who was named Freemason of the Century, wrote that Freemasonry is a religion and that initiates are intentionally misled until they reach the highest levels. He wrote that Freemasonry is an outer organization concealing an inner brotherhood, one visible and one invisible. The invisible is dedicated to the service of a mysterious Arcanum Arcanorum. Having a belief in a supreme being is required to become a Mason. And the atheist is looked upon by the Mason as being the most vulgar and despicable of mankind. But who is the supreme being in Masonry?
Freemasonry is Satanism in disguise.
33rd degree Sovereign Grand Commander of the Scottish Rite, Albert Pike, wrote in Morals and Dogma that Lucifer is the light bearer. 33rd degree Mason Albert Mackey wrote that Lucifer is good, light, victory, and initiation. And 33rd degree Freemason of the Century, Manly P. Hall, wrote that the mystery of the craft is the seething, surging energies of Lucifer that can be wielded by the initiate. This is the symbol for Satanism, and this is the symbol for female Freemasonry, the Order of the Eastern Star. The Satanic Bible lists Baphomet as the symbol of Satan worshipped by the highest level of Freemasonry, the Templar Masons. In the Satanic rituals, it is written that Masonic orders contain the most influential men in government, and virtually every occult order has Masonic roots, and that every rite of the Nazis' Black Order employed Masonic principles. Both Satanism and Masonic rituals involve the goat, the coffin, and the death's head. Anton LaVey wrote that the Masonic rituals serve as a screening process for organized Satanism. Freemasons can also be seen making the 666 hand gesture.
I'm a Christian, sir.
I'm pure and virtuous and wholesome and innocent. How can you say anything about me?
Sir, you need to be born again.
I am born again.
Now, did you just say that you are Lucifer?
I am Lucifer.
Okay, define Lucifer for me.
Pure, virtuous, wholesome, innocent individual that's out to help people.
Lucifer is?
Yeah.
Say that again. Lucifer is a pure, holy...
Virtuous.
Now, see the Lucifer that God created?
That's the same one.
At the highest level of the so-called Illuminati is a perverted sex cult, which is why high-level Mason Walt Disney not only saturated his films with Masonic hand gestures and 666, but also added subliminal images with hidden sexuality. Altiyan claims that the square and compass are actually symbolizing the sex act, the woman's legs spread open and a man mounting her. The G symbolizes the generative principle of creation. The all-seeing eye symbolizes the head of the penis, and the rays shooting forth the orgasm. Each year, 13 high-level Masons may be invited to join the top of this monstrous pyramid, the Royal Order of Jesters, dedicated to nothing but sexual depravity.
There is no sin. There is only nature. Why do you think that witchcraft has disappeared? It never disappeared. It was hidden, forced to go into hiding by the appearance of Jesus on the human scene. Another reason why he's passionately hated.
33rd degree Mason Aleister Crowley wrote how he pecks at the eyes of Jesus on the cross, how the New Age will arise from the destruction of Christianity, and how all children shall be accustomed from infancy to witness every type of sexual act. According to the Royal Art of Freemasonry, magic is the highest and most divine. And what is this magic?
Any living being is a storehouse of energy, varying in quantity according to the size and health of the animal. At the death of the animal, this energy is liberated suddenly. The animal, therefore, should be killed within the circle. For the highest spiritual working, one must accordingly choose that victim which contains the greatest and purest force, a male child.
We are witnessing the culmination of their mysterious arcanum, the destruction of Christianity and the mass sacrifice of humanity. Created in 1979 by the Masonic Order of the Rose Cross, the first Luciferian commandment carved into the Georgia Guidestones is to maintain humanity under 500 million in perpetual balance with nature. High-level Mason Friedrich Nietzsche wrote how Christianity is more harmful than any vice and considered Christians sick animals. Their utopian New Age, as written about in the Satanic Bible and in the Lucius Trust, consultants to the European Union, is nothing more than the absolute destruction of Christianity. Aleister Crowley wrote how the people need to be ruled by the state and the world must be bathed in blood to usher in the New Age. Subversion of all governments and world religions has been going on in secrecy for centuries. Religious leaders, heads of state, and your favorite pop stars have practically all been absorbed into this hidden hand of Satanism. In 1991, the Noahide laws were signed into U.S. law by Skull and Bones member George Bush. Once these laws are practiced openly, it will be blasphemy to call Jesus Christ your Lord and Savior, punishable by death. They want to bring us back to the days of blood sacrifice. Whether you believe or not, the culture of compassion, mercy, and love is Christian. Christ ended the days of blood sacrifice. Christ forgave us of our sins, all of us, liberated us, so that no man could stand between the individual and God. It's no wonder why they hide in the shadows. With a religion based on their own weakness, their so-called magic is nothing other than ruthless thuggery and deceit. Like broken animals, they fear the true light and want to drag you into the darkness with them. Don't let them.